Morning students. Now today in chapter 2 business service 1 we are going to learn about postal services. Yesterday class we have learned the insurance services. Now the another most important service you must have observed, that is post and telecommunication department run by the government of India. Again after independence government realized that our postal and communication department has to be upgraded, then only the economic growth and development of the country possible. So the postal department, the post office, the post head office and the other offices of the post you must have visited. What you observed over there, the postal services play a very important role in the return information. When you want to write something and if you want to send something, as well as the communication department also is associated, where you are using your telephone, your mobile, your all the communication tools which we are using, and communication is associated with that. The government and the private postal services, the parcel services are also there. These services in which you may have observed the couriers are there, angadiyas are there, and our regular post parcel services are also there. They play an important role to pass information and the parcels from one place to another. Our main purpose is that we want connectivity. Nowadays you all are using WhatsApp, the tool by which we are just now doing our teaching learning process. That is because of the well-established communication service. So communication has reduced the distance and communication has made it so much speedy activity in the world economic ground. So it helps people to grow, develop and the economy to develop. In India, for the more than 150 years, it is so old that before independence, even the Britishers, they have also tried and attempted that the postal service are the most essential. As the Indian Railway, in the same manner, the postal department and the Indian Railway established initially by the Britishers, and then we have developed it later on. Here, these services are available. There are more than 1,50,000 post offices in our country. The total number of post office, postal department is a very big source of employment. The people are employed there and government solve the problem of unemployment with the help of up to and great extent with postal department. The post office in India, out of these almost 90% set up in the rural area. Why the rural area selected for postal department? The reason is that all the nationalized and all the private banks, they are not ready to go to the rural areas because business is less. Without business, they have to bear a loss and nobody want to go there. So only the government sector, the postal department, go open their branch over there, and with that the so many purposes are served. One, communication can be maintained, another, information can be maintained, and third, so many functions are done by the postal department which already covered the banking facilities for the rural people. So 90% are set up in the rural area itself. Now let us see the services, that is what provided by the postal department. Postal department does so many functions that you have not up till now experienced. So next time when you visit to the postal department, you see the sections and the per employees, those who are working over there, it is written which services are provided by them. There are many services for the postal department. The very first is that general post and the letters. Unfortunately, you people may not have seen that yellow envelope, that yellow postcard used to come. Then the inland letter, the blue letter used to come. Then we have that for the foreign country, aerograms, that used to be there. envelopes, yellow envelopes used to be there. So all these are the general post. Now during the days of as the Raksha Bandhan nearby, your mother must have put that Rakhi and the letter into that yellow envelope and must be posted. So the general post are there, the letters are there. In a e-commerce and with that electronic gadget, we are now communicating easily without using this general post. But in the rural area, people still today also using this general post. The next is, that is the registered post. See, the problem with the general post, it may happen that your post may not reach to the destiny. If you want to make it ensure that your letter has to reach to the other party, then along with your envelope, you are also adding one additional paper on which the sender name and the receiver name and addresses are written. So when the letter reaches to the receiver, he sign on it, and again that letter will come back to the sender. So which ensures that your post is definitely received by the receiver. So here for the registered post, you have to pay little extra to the post office. Then there are the parcel services. The postal department also do the parcel services. Two ways are there: COD, that is cash on delivery, and VPP, value payable post. Again, in these two methods, you are ensuring that parcel definitely received by the receiver, because the payment to be received at the point of receiver. So that parcel services are available and your goods can also be transferred from one place to another. The speed post. Now people don't have a time, and the speed parcel, people want everything to be done speedy. So apart from your general post and register, still you want a speed, then you have to pay higher charges, because your letter will go by air, and in a very stipulated time your delivery of the letter will be ensured. Even you have the track information, the barcode, track barcode, you can trace your letter where your envelope is and to what distance the envelope has just received. So in this manner, the speed post also help. The next is, that is express parcel. The general parcel you are sending, if you want that parcel to go little fast, as the general post and the speed post, like that, the general parcel service and the express parcel service, you pay more, the priority will be given to you and your letter and parcel will go faster. Now, the general saving schemes are offered by the postal department. As I said, that 1,50,000 post office are there, more are in rural area. Why? Because they also do the banking activity. They provide the saving services. They encourage people to save. So how many ways are there that they are allowing people to save? They do work like a bank account, savings account in the bank. We have learned that whatever extra money you have, you keep into your savings account, and the post department will give you interest on your savings. So you can open your savings account. You can have the 5 years recurring deposit account. Every month, a part of money you keep on depositing. The total accumulated money along with the interest you will get back. So like this, you can accumulate your money and the big amount of fund can be collected together. So 5 year recurring deposits are there. Term deposits, the normal term deposit, fixed deposit. Term deposit means fixed. You keep your money for 1 year, 3 year, 5 year or 7 year according to your desire, and accordingly you will get your interest. Then you have the monthly income plan. This is very common, that all the retired people, the housewife and those who don't have a regular income, they prefer that every month the interest to be paid to them. And so for monthly income plan, they go to the post office and deposit their money. Senior citizen savings plan, mainly for the senior citizen, because they are retired, they need a money more. So normal rate of interest over and above, some more interest is given to the senior citizen looking to their age and financial need. You have the senior citizen plan from the government side. It is launched and post office is offering that plan. Then you must have heard about Kishan Vikas Patra. Again, a Kishan Vikas Patra, that is a one kind of a document certificate given by the post that you have kept so and so amount into the post, and that money will be given to you back on the expiry of that tenure. In between, if you want, you can mortgage or you can otherwise the fixed term is there for the Kishan Vikas Patra. Like that, to encourage the savings for the girl child, you have that Sukanya, that is Samruddhi account. For the welfare of the girls, as you know that you have to manage for the finance for the marriages of the girl and all, a long-term saving plan are offered by the post office. They do give. Nowadays, the post office also provide the services of a checkbook. They do give checkbook, like a savings account you are opening, you need a checkbook. So post office provide that. They also started the ATM facility like a bank. You have the debit card and you can use the ATM of the postal department, and that facility is also there. The next is, that is a recurring deposit. We have already discussed over here that regularly you deposit your money and you will get rate of interest little again higher, and here the benefit is part investment is possible. You have the term deposit, as we said included here, that it may be 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 5 year, according to the limit you decide, you can keep and deposit. And the rate of interest given to you. The National Savings Certificate, NSE, the Kishan Vikas Patra, that is also the deposit which double the investment amount after 100 month. The Kishan Vikas Patra duration is 100 month. 100 month means 8 years and 4 month. So these are the very well known certificate issued, and the people generally faith more in the postal department investment. The reason is that government of India, it is one department run by the central government. So people have more faith that my money are safe and I can keep my more money into the postal department. Now another one more important thing, that is Public Provident Fund, PPF account, you can open with the post office. Now PPF, this account is decided that to be open for 15 years, and minimum every year you have to invest 500 minimum per annum. 500 rupee has to be deposited and you cannot withdraw, close your account before 15 years. Even after 15 years, if you want, you can extend your account for further 5 years again and again. So 15, then plus 5, 20, then plus 5, 25, then plus 5, 30, like that. But for that, your concern should be there. You have to instruct the postal department to extend your account. Here you are getting the tax benefit. Why people prefer to invest into PPF? There are two reasons. One, the rate of interest is more. And the second, you get an exemption of income tax with the help of investment into the PPF. So public prefer to deposit their money in the PPF account. Next is, that is a postal insurance known as a PLI. Postal life insurance only available to the government employees. Either a central government, state government or a semi-government employee, they can only buy the postal life insurance policy. Here the main thing is that lowest premium to be paid and maximum bonus offered to them. So government employee, for their life protection over and above other instrument, the PLI is available, made is available by the government. Next is, that is a monthly income scheme. We have already discussed over here, known as a MIS, that you put your money and instruct the post office to give you interest monthly. So all the retired people and housewife and other people, those who want regular income, they get the benefit out of it. Here also the rate of interest is comparatively little high than the normal rate of interest. Next is that money order. If you want to send money from one place to another, nowadays we have a Paytm and we have an Bheem app and we have that is the banking, online net banking. But once upon a time, we are talking about 150 years back, no such type of facilities were available. So at that time, to send the money from one place to another was a big headache. So only the post office can help you in sending your money. So here, the sender has to pay commission. When you want to send your money, the total amount of money what you want to send plus the charges for the commission, that also you have to pay to the postal department. Receiver, when he receive the money, he has to sign and the document again will back to the person sender that yes, my money delivered and the receiver has received. Once upon a time, as I say, during the Raksha Bandhan and all, so many brothers, they do give that money order to the their sisters. And like this, the money transfer. There are two ways of transferring money. That is the instant money order that is done with the help of the fast communication system. And nowadays, it is more is that is EMO, that is electronic money order. With the help of the internet and email, the very quick and spontaneous transfer of money possible. So these are the system by which the money can be sent. The other related services the post office also provide are that is the purchase and sale of the foreign currency. When you want to do the foreign trade, you need a foreign currency. The postal department can manage that like other bank, SBI and all, the foreign currency can be received. They also provide the traveler's check. When you want to go abroad and you want a traveler's check, you can approach the bank, post office, and post office will give you that traveler's check. The debit card, as I said, ATM is there, so debit card going to be there, provided by the postal department. The mutual fund. Every day you see the advertisement on television regarding mutual fund. So people are crazy about investing their money through the mutual fund. So in the various schemes of mutual fund, the post office help you in investing your money. The government of India, whosoever launch any scheme, most of the schemes are covered by the postal department. Over and above, the postal department also provides services of collection of the municipal taxes, of the GEB bill or of the gas bill and all. In and all, postal department does many more services and it is a part and parcel of our life. Without a postal department and without a communication, main is the communication services, telecommunication services, it is difficult for us to survive. So in this manner, the postal department and postal services played a very important role in the economic growth and development of the country.